feel like showering more than once a day or every day is such a white people thing. Oh. Who said this? Naya Rivera, Chris Rock, or Rihanna?
Chris Rock?
Not Chris Rock, no. Naya Rivera said it the other day on The View.
Oh,
it's okay, we got a prize for you anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. $150 gift card. Visa, Visa, Visa. That's what you're getting, and thank you so much for being here, and we'll be right back.
Cetaphil cleans without stripping for healthy, hydrated skin every day. But how will that gentle power make you feel? Beautiful.
Let's give it up for checks in our mailboxes and safer streets in our community. The Allstate Safe Driving Bonus Check. Get one every 6 months, you're accident-free. Let's give it up for good.
His paddleboard was found, but not the local man missing for a week. New information on the search. Plus, shopping now for school uniforms. Did the research comparing stores to find the best deals. Next on WPTV News Channel 5 at 5.
Did you steal this thing? Honestly. Because with all this stuff, and, of course, the way it drives, maybe you really are getting away with something.
It's that time of year when smart shoppers make their move. Schumacher's summer sell down. Sign and drive Buick Encore for $189 a month, zero down. Plus there's 0% APR for 60 months. Only at Schumacher.
If I were hurt by a big truck, I'd call Rubenstein Law.
If I fell on someone else's property, I'd call Rubenstein Law.
If I lost a family member to an accident, I would call Rubenstein Law.
Rubenstein Law recently got a client $850,000 for a car accident.
Rubenstein Law got $750,000 for a client who had a serious hand injury.
When you need an attorney, call Rubenstein Law.
I'm attorney Robert Rubenstein. Call me. I want to be your attorney.
Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL.
When you commit to South University, we commit to you. When you answer the call to ministry, we deliver coursework that guides you down the right path. When you devote yourself to a higher calling, we help you succeed on your terms. When you decide to turn your spirituality into ministry, we're here for you. When you invest in your future, we make your time worth it. For information about ministry or other programs, call South University or visit us online. We're ready for you.
Pleasure, my co-host, my studio audience. Fabulous job today. Yeah. Have a wonderful weekend. I love you for watching, and I'll see you next time on Wendy. Bye.
The Now South Florida, stories everyone's talking about right now.
Making sure you're in the know.
With new information before everyone else.
It's a bold new way to get your news. The Now South Florida, weekdays at 4 on WPTV News Channel 5.
It's Bassett's half-off weekend. Get special half-off savings, plus save 25% store-wide. Friday, half-off dining tables. Saturday, half-off beds and select mattress sets. And Sunday, half-off accent chairs and recliners. Don't miss Bassett's half-off weekend.
Excellence. How do you find it? It's fueled by passion, thrives on persistence, and demands nothing less than total dedication. My name is Mark Anajar.
And I'm Glenn Levine.
Our mission to deliver excellence in legal services is what makes a world of difference. Call the law offices of Banninger & Levine at 1-800-747-FREE for a consultation.
Catch your News Channel 5 updates throughout the day on News Radio WJNO.
First of all, this is still an active and open search. We are searching today. However, we have made a decision that we will suspend at sunset tonight.
Heart-wrenching, devastating, the words none of us wanted to hear, but the family and many others still not giving up hope that Austin and Perry will be found. It's 4 o'clock in South Florida, and this is the Now. Good afternoon. I'm Ashley Henson in for Shannon Cake today. We have team coverage on that search for Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen in just a moment. But first, some strong storms on the radar. Meteorologist James Whelan is in the Weather Center with me tracking all of that. What are we looking at, James?
Yeah, we just had a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Indian River County. So we're going to get right to that first here. And that goes until 4:30, although it may be dropped a little bit sooner because these storms are moving quickly. Also a marine warning with it too. And this is the storm we're talking about here. It's just about right on top of Sebastian. 50 to 60 plus mile per hour winds with this as it moves on through. Some lightning strikes there and some real heavy downpours, blinding rain out there as it moves over the island and then offshore. The severe thunderstorm warning again goes until 4:30. But we're already seeing the heaviest part of the storm, the strongest part of the storm starting to move offshore right now. So it may be dropped before that. We have another line back behind this that will swing on through western Indian River County here in the course of the next hour. Plus, Palm Beach County finally getting in on the action here with strong thunderstorms from West Palm southward through Boynton, Boca Raton. This again will increase in coverage as we go into the next couple of hours. Some of these, although right now they're not severe. Some of these could pop up severe too, and we'll keep you posted on that. We have the crawl going at the bottom of your screen. That will be the very latest information there, and we'll also keep you posted on where these are headed, which is back towards the coast. More coming up a little bit later.
All right, Ashley. James, thank you so much. Right now, you are looking at live pictures from the Square Grouper in Jupiter. In just about an hour, people will start gathering for a night of hope, hoping to find 14-year-old Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen. You can see they're getting ready there, blue balloons, hoping to find these boys, hoping for a miracle. Jay Cashmere will broadcast live from the Square Grouper beginning at 5 tonight. Now, right now, the U.S. Coast Guard is in what may prove to be the final hours of the search for Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen. The 14-year-olds were last seen a week ago today on a boat at the Jupiter Inlet. This video here shows the conditions they were facing that afternoon. We have live team coverage. Brian Enten is live at the family's homes. But first, we want to begin with the Now's Jared Werksma. He is live from the Coast Guard station in Miami. Jared.
Well, we just got off the phone with one of the PAOs with the U.S. Coast Guard, and we are looking for any new information right now, obviously, about what exactly is going on with the search. They have told us today repeatedly that if they find any new information while they are out there on the ocean, they are going to continue to look for these boys. However, if they do not find any more information, this could be the last couple of hours of this search that has gone on for more than 7 days now and has proved to be one of the largest in the U.S. Coast Guard's history. The Coast Guard says it conducted 66 search patterns over nearly 50,000 square nautical miles of ocean while searching for Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen. With 26 planes, 4 helicopters, 31 boats, and hundreds of local, state, and federal personnel. Still, Coast Guard Captain Mark Fedor admitted this afternoon he doesn't expect those numbers to be any comfort to Austin and Perry's family members.
So I do want to express my heartfelt condolences to the family. I have a 14-year-old and a 13-year-old. So the decision to suspend was excruciating and gut-wrenching for me personally.
All right, now once again, the U.S. Coast Guard says that if they do not find new evidence, they will be suspending the search for Austin and Perry tonight at sunset. But once again, they do want to focus on the part that they're saying suspended. Any new information that could continue this search, and they say that there is any number of things that could cause them to continue it. We are waiting for word from them right now. You can follow us, obviously, on air and online. We'll have updates for you throughout the night. You can also follow me at Jared Werksma. And as soon as we have any word from the Coast Guard, we will be sure to fill you in. But for now, we are live from the Coast Guard station in Opa-locka. I'm Jared Werksma for the Now.
And despite the Coast Guard suspending their search, the boys' families say they aren't giving up. Our team coverage continues with the Now's Brian Enten. He is live now. Brian, what do you have for us?
Families right now are not giving up hope. They are inside their homes, including the home behind me, working feverishly to find additional private pilots. The stepfather of Perry just coming out a little while ago and saying they are looking for military pilots, retired military pilots who have search and rescue experience. They are not going to stop searching for those boys.
Austin and Perry's family members embrace each other as they continue to work behind the scenes, determined to keep up the momentum to find the boys. The family released this statement today. Our families have been informed that the continued search and rescue efforts will be suspended at sunset this evening. We also have been ensured that the case is not closed, and if pertinent details emerge or credible information comes forward, that we will have the assistance of the U.S. Coast Guard. Our families are committed to continue the search and rescue efforts of our boys with the aid of volunteer pilots and aircraft. The Perry and Austin Rescue Fund GoFundMe is now up to over $300,000, and a fundraiser is planned for tonight at the Square Grouper in Jupiter to raise more money for the private search.
If you are retired military with an expertise in search and rescue, Perry's stepfather is asking that you email findperryandaustin@gmail.com. Meanwhile, today, Congressman Patrick Murphy sent out a statement urging the Coast Guard not to stop with their search. He says he still has hope that those boys are alive because the temperature of the ocean is so high, it's so warm right now, and because he says those boys were so experienced on the water. Live in Tequesta, I'm Brian Enten for the Now.
And stay with News Channel 5 and WPTV.com for any new information on this search for Austin and Perry. Remember, you can get push alerts on the search automatically sent to your phone 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. All you have to do, just download the WPTV app.
This is easily one of the most violent scenes that I've ever been to. And it's made more horrific by the fact that PJ definitely saw what happened to his parents.
Today, Orlando police announced they need the public's help finding who murdered a young couple in front of their two-year-old son. The couple grew up in Palm Beach County, but recently had moved to Orlando. Now, Tanya Rogers joins us from the feed room with more on what happened. Tanya?
Well, Ashley, Orlando police would not share details on how the couple was killed, but the tragedy has left two families in mourning. Orlando police say on July 17th, they were alerted to a disturbance in an apartment complex. They found 26-year-old Renee Collins and her boyfriend, 25-year-old Peterson Delhomme, dead. Their two-year-old son, PJ, who they say saw what happened, was not harmed. We're told Delhomme's funeral is this weekend. Now, Collins, a Royal Palm Beach High School graduate, was buried last weekend. Neighbors who knew Collins since she was a little girl are saddened.
The funeral was held last Saturday morning, and we went. And I didn't go up to the casket because I wanted to remember her as she was. Vibrant. Running all over the place, busy, you know, I wanted to remember that way.
Now, no arrests have been made in the case. Now, that's why police are asking for the public's help. Now, as part of the investigation, police are looking to see if there could be any connection to their past here in our area. Reporting live, I'm Tanya Rogers for the Now.
And turning to presidential politics right now, five candidates vying to be the next commander-in-chief, speaking at the National Urban League Conference in Fort Lauderdale. Among them, Democrat Hillary Clinton and Republican Jeb Bush.
I don't think you can credibly say that everyone has a right to rise and then say you're for phasing out Medicare or for repealing Obamacare. People can't rise if they can't afford health care.
Trust in our vital institutions is at historic lows. It's up to all of us to work diligently to rebuild that trust. That happens one person at a time, one politician at a time, one police officer at a time.
Now, gauging from the applause at this event, Hillary did have a stronger connection with the voters here, but she also made more defined attacks at her Republican opponents and proving you're never too old to tweet. Former President George H.W. Bush giving a big thumbs up from his summer home in Maine. Look at this. He is recovering from a fall 2 weeks ago, but he looks as happy as ever, doesn't he? He broke a bone in his neck and is expected to make a full recovery. He tweeted a photo to his 177,000 followers saying, "Who knew jumping out of planes was safer than getting out of bed? Thanks to all for your kind get well wishes." You'll recall he went skydiving for his 90th birthday last year. I still can't believe he went skydiving at 90. And he's tweeting at 90. He's an impressive guy. Pretty cool. Okay, West Palm Beach community leaders, they're calling for peace after a deadly spree of shootings last week. The Now's Alyssa Hyman joining us live from Friendship Missionary Baptist Church on 3rd Street with how the community is now taking action. Alyssa.
Well, in just a few hours from now, city leaders, religious leaders, and community members will be gathering here at the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church for a community peace walk. What they're going to do is they're going to be walking from this location on 3rd Street all the way down north to Tamarind, and it's about 2.5 miles as they walk to the different locations of the shootings from last week. The whole point is to have a presence in the community. Now, last week, four people lost their lives to gun violence here in West Palm Beach just last week alone. Police and the mayor saying there are gangs retaliating against one another, a cycle of violence the community wants to see end, and the mayor says it all starts with visibility in the community.
Hopefully, the more they see us in the neighborhood, we'll be able to build up a level of trust, and folks will know that if they need help, they can reach out to us.
Now, the march will start here at 6 o'clock. Again, we are on 3rd Street at the Missionary Baptist, Friendship Missionary Baptist Church. There is a little rain right now, so let's hope that stops for this peace walk. Reporting live in West Palm Beach, Alyssa Hyman for the News South Florida.
Coming up on the Now, outrage around the world over the American who killed Cecil the Lion. Will he get the punishment people are calling for? The latest next. Plus, most schools block students' access to social media on campus, but some teachers trying to change all of that. Why educators are embracing Twitter and similar sites. And a determined teen financing her college education with a little creativity and a lot of duct tape. How she got thousands of dollars for school.
Criminals look for weakness to violate your trust and take what you cherish most. September 14th, while they're looking for you, we're looking for them. We're busting bad guys, exposing scammers.
You scammed enough people.
You're a psychic. You know what's coming next?
And investigating chilling mysteries.
Is he a smooth criminal who got away with murder?
Primetime Crime is coming to daytime. Crime Watch Daily.
Starting September 14th on WPTV.
It's the I-95 RV Show in Port St. Lucie. You'll save thousands on a new or used RV. Like this new Winnebago Mini, discounted to just $140 per month. The I-95 RV Show is going on now at La Mesa RV in Port St. Lucie.
Ava and I needed a little vacay, but we needed to watch our spending. Meaning I needed to watch Nikki. She's the spender. I'm the saver. So mobile banking from TD Bank helps me keep track. For both of us.
She was just browsing. We gotta go.
I'm Ava.
I'm Nikki. And we bank human at TD Bank.
What?
Want to take your dorm room from plain to insane?
Then you gotta go to Ross.
You'll find everything you need.
For so much less.
Look at all the great stuff we got.
And we saved so much.
You'll get organized,
colorized,
and accessorized.
Looks amazing.
Totally.
So if you want to save a bunch
and be the envy of your dorm,
you gotta go to Ross.
You gotta go to Ross.
It's H.H. Gregg's Super Sale. Get zero down and zero interest till January 2018. A Samsung 32-inch LED TV, just $198. Or a 55-inch LED TV, just
$398. Gregg's got it.
Now through Saturday. Zero down and zero interest till January 2018 at H.H. Gregg. Top brands, low prices, fast delivery.
Gregg's got it.
This is the last weekend to take advantage of the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale, where you'll find incredible once-a-season savings in every department. Dramatic summer clearance sale reductions on our incomparable room packages. Save big on a ton of special clearance buys. There's even interest-free financing. But when it's gone, it's gone. So don't wait. Hurry to the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale before it ends at 9 p.m. Monday. It's the perfect time to buy furniture.
It's the I-95 RV Show in Port St. Lucie. You'll save thousands on a new or used RV. Like this new Fleetwood Storm, discounted to just $401 per month. The I-95 RV Show is going on now at La Mesa RV in Port St. Lucie.
Zimbabwe is now working to extradite the Minnesota dentist who killed Cecil the Lion to face charges. Investigators believe Walter Palmer paid a guide $50,000 to hunt the lion who was collared and part of a conservation study on a wild animal sanctuary. Now, Zimbabwe officials also say Palmer used a crossbow, which caused the lion to suffer a slow death. The White House is reviewing a public petition with 170,000 signatures calling for Palmer to be extradited to Zimbabwe. The U.S. Justice Department has not yet made a decision on that. And someone taped a threatening sign to Palmer's vacation home in Southwest Florida. If and when Palmer decides to pay a visit to his Marco Island home, he will have a very unpleasant surprise waiting for him. It reads, "You are an abomination. The world will hunt you down." In the center of the sign, within a circle reading Cecil Innocence, is a stuffed baby lion. You see it right there. Okay, a Shell Oil icebreaker is now headed for an Arctic drilling operation following a showdown with protesters. Yesterday morning, protesters hung from the St. John Bridge in Portland, Oregon, so that the Fennica would not be able to pass through. They were also paddling kayaks in the water below. The ship tried to leave earlier in the day but was forced to return to the dock because of the demonstration against Arctic oil drilling. Well, it's almost back to school season. As parents and students scout school supplies, teachers prepare lesson plans for a new crop of students. The Now's John Favoli found they are finding social ways to keep kids focused on learning.
The halls are empty, but teachers at this charter school in Charlotte are preparing for a new year and some new policies.
We'll need to block sites like Facebook and Twitter and Kick and Snapchat.
No doubt some students will try to bend the rules.
The cell phone down by your waist and texting inside their big sweatshirt. Kids texting behind their back.
But instead of banning social media, some educators are embracing it.
Why not use these tools in the classroom to promote learning?
Michelle Haken is a middle school English teacher in New York who was tired of traditional book reports. She started a social media discussion group with her class. Students with parental consent would meet on Twitter.
To share books and conversations, to interact and collaborate, not only in the classroom, but on a global scale.
Even when social media is not in the classroom, some teachers use it after school for online office hours or homework help.
They were more proud of their homework the next day because they didn't just slap something down on paper, but they really thought through those problems.
The teachers also see their efforts reinforcing the positive use of social media.
Providing young people with the 21st century skills that they need to succeed.
In an ever-changing world of communication.
Keep in mind that some social networks have restrictions. For example, users must be at least 13 years old to use Twitter. Ashley, back to you.
All right, John, thanks. And keep in mind that some social networks have restrictions. For example, users must be at least 13 years old to use Twitter as well. Now, keeping in that back-to-school theme here, this weekend is another chance to get your kids their booster immunization shots. New and transferring students, as well as those entering seventh grade, will need to provide proof of vaccinations prior to enrollment. So if your child is missing any of those, the County Health Department offers all of those required for school at its health centers and on the immunization van.
The van will be at the Palm Springs Baptist Church tomorrow between 9 and 2. And by the way, those shots are free. And don't forget about our Back to School Expo. We're excited about this. It's Saturday, August 8th at the mall at Wellington Green from 10 until 4. We are getting you guys ready, your entire family ready, when it comes to school supplies, school uniforms, everything you need to know. Plus, you can meet the members of our news team as well. We'll be there. And already this year, 11 children have died from heat stroke inside vehicles. And now parents across the country, they're taking action. It's the perfect timing, too, for the reminder. As the Now's Julie Dolan tells us, today is National Heat Stroke Prevention and Awareness Day.
Where are the parents?
This week, police broke into a minivan parked outside a New Jersey Costco to rescue a little girl locked inside. Minutes later, the mother returns. In this case, the mother was charged with child endangerment, and bystanders say she's lucky it wasn't worse. 37 children die of heat stroke in cars every year. That's one every 10 days. And that's why a group of grieving parents are taking action. They wrote a letter to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration urging lawmakers to find technical and common sense solutions to prevent parents from leaving kids in cars.
One time I did almost forget.
A Kentucky mother says it can happen to anyone.
I drove straight to work. And before I even pulled in the parking lot, as I was turning in, I realized I had forgotten to take her to the babysitter.
Dads are guilty, too, like one in Boston who made a frantic call to 911 earlier this year.
I left my one-year-old baby in my SUV by accident.
That child was also rescued in time. According to kidsincars.org, in about 50% of cases, a parent unknowingly leaves the kid behind. And on an 80-degree day, your car can reach 120 degrees in an hour. So, what can you do? Experts have a few tips, like putting your briefcase, purse, or cell phone next to the car seat, set a daily alarm on your phone, and always look before you lock. For the Now, I'm Julie Dolan.
Definitely some great tips, especially living here in South Florida when it gets really, really hot. But yeah. I want to mention, we are hearing some rumbling out there yeah. from inside the studio. Thunder is hitting us here in West Palm Beach right now.
Yes, and a lot of rain, too. And the radar just lighting up here in Palm Beach County and along the Treasure Coast, too. Live Vapor 5 Max. So we have a few things going on. That severe thunderstorm that was up to the north, that's gone now. That pushed offshore and weakened. We also had a severe thunderstorm down to the south in Broward County. That one is gone, too. We have a couple significant weather advisories. This for this line right here into Okeechobee County, Western Indian River County. This goes until 5:15 as this kind of slowly works off towards the northeast. Once it runs into the area that already been worked over, it will diminish though. But where it hasn't is down to the south and even up into Martin County. So that's where we're going to look for showers and storms to still start firing up through the afternoon and evening hours here. Look at this, just big thunderstorm. Could have 50 mile per hour winds with this, some small hail, numerous lightning strikes, heavy downpours up and down the turnpike right here, probably blinding rain there, so you want to be careful of that. And this is spreading eastward towards I-95, up towards West Palm, too, seeing some heavy rain. Let's go farther north, Palm Beach Gardens, Riviera Beach, all starting to pick up on the action, too. This will continue to build northward, too, up towards Juneau Beach. So I've kept the rain chances really in the forecast for you going into the evening hours. For anything severe out there, of course, we'll break in here. And also the bottom of your screen has some important information. A good time to download the Storm Shield app, too, because wherever you are, it's going to pop up right on your phone if you're in the path of that severe thunderstorm. Ashley?
Good to know, James. Thanks so much. Right now, you are looking live at the Night of Hope for Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen at the Square Grouper in Jupiter. The community will be coming out tonight to support the family and the continued search efforts for those two boys at this event, scheduled to start in less than an hour. You see their pictures there, balloons hanging. People will start to file in about half an hour, like we mentioned. But as we told you earlier, the U.S. Coast Guard telling us today they will suspend the search for these boys at sundown tonight. But people still going to support that family at this event. The family says they are not giving up hope.
It's our anniversary sale, and we're celebrating over 85 years of comfort. Save 20% store-wide with a donation of $20 or more to Ronald McDonald House Charities. You'll feel good in more ways than one. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
this Thursday through Saturday at Bell's. Backed by popular demand, 40% off savings throughout the store, including your favorite brands not normally on sale. All tees and shorts, all outdoors, all dresses, all intimates, all home, all ladies sportswear, all Carter's, all now 40% off. Plus, take an extra 40% off all clearance and get $10 in Bell's Bucks for every $50 you spend. Take 40% off store-wide. Limited brand exclusions apply. See store for details. Shop extended hours all 3 days, Thursday through Saturday only. All your favorite back-to-school brands and more. Bell's.
Nissan Altima. With up to 270 horsepower, blind spot warning, and premium interior. For a limited time, lease Altima, just $179 per month, or save up to $3,525. Altima, the ride you can always rely on. Shop your local Nissan store and choose Nissan.com. Innovation that excites.
At K-12, we believe that every child is uniquely brilliant. Some are curious. Others inventive. Passionate. Even outside the box. So they deserve an education designed for them. K-12 is available through tuition-free online public schools. Taught by highly qualified, state-certified teachers, it's a full-time option that allows parents and students to individualize their education. K-12 programs teach to and embrace your child's unique brilliance, enhancing their ability to succeed. Join the growing community of K-12 families who have succeeded with an individually tailored, tuition-free online education. Call now or visit k12.com to learn more. Tuition-free for K-12 students in Florida.
I ain't got nobody, nobody, nobody knows, oh, the trouble I've seen. I so sad and lonely, 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 want some sweet mama.
Circe, Denny, Scarola, Barnhart, and Shipley, attorneys at law, taking time to care.
It's Bassett's half-off weekend. Get special half-off savings, plus save 25% store-wide. Friday, half-off dining tables. Saturday, half-off beds and select mattress sets. And Sunday, half-off accent chairs and recliners. Don't miss Bassett's half-off weekend.
A couple of girls go on a ride called the Slingshot in Spain, but one of them won't remember the entire ride. Let's check in with our friends at Right This Minute for more.
What's up, The Now? I'm Nick Calderon.
And I'm Christiane Vera. Nick, this is your kind of video. These Irish girls at a theme park in Spain on a ride called the Slingshot. You can tell right off the bat they're already psyching themselves out. They're freaking out. You know it's going to be a good one.
The girl on the left already looks like she's about to puke. I can't wait to see what happens when they pull the trigger.
Oh, yeah. And there they go. One of them loses consciousness almost at the very beginning, comes right back to... starts screaming because she can't believe it just happened, but it happens again.
I can't watch this enough. Put this on a 10-hour loop, bow it up for me, and give it to me for Christmas. I love it.
Too good.
We got more great videos just like that on Right This Minute.
That poor girl. Hope she's okay. You can catch the full episode of Right This Minute at 7:30 p.m. right after the list.
Tracking some strong thunderstorms that are firing up all over Palm Beach County now and the Treasure Coast. First, let's stop into South County right now. Boca, you're okay at the moment, but storms are looming on your back door here. This could fill in as we go into the afternoon, latter part of the afternoon and evening. Up towards Boynton, Hypoluxo, Lake Worth, just to the west of 95. Those areas seeing some torrential rains now. Up and down the turnpike, heavy rains. Could have some 50 plus mile per hour winds with this too. Some small hail also possible with this. Notice starting to weaken a little bit, but it's also building up to the north. So now moving into West Palm Beach, pushing up to the north towards Riviera Beach and North Palm 2. Let's go farther up to the north here and see it's starting to build into the gardens. Juneau Beach starting to see just to your south, and this will continue to build northward too up towards Jupiter. So expect a slow go of it up and down the roadways with this heavy, heavy rain up and down 95 and the turnpike too. We're keeping the rain chance through the evening till just after sunset, maybe 9, 10 o'clock or so. We'll see it start to diminish. Ashley?
All right, James, thanks. A local after-school program in danger of shutting down in an area where families need it most. What's threatening to cause it to close? Next on The Now. Plus, besides the cost, the worst part of eating out is the wait, right? Well, how your smartphone could cut down on that and make your experience a whole lot more enjoyable. Still to come. Stay with us.
Fresh off the list, freeze your fat away. Yes, science has proven it works. And keep your canine cool this summer with these three things. If it's totally rad, it's on the list.
Tonight at 7 on News Channel 5.
Get the hottest looks at the back-to-school sale at Shoe Carnival. Dance for the whole family starting at $34.98. And cool athletic style starting at $44.98. Plus, buy one, get one half off, even sale prices. Shop Shoe Carnival today. Shoe Carnival, a surprise in store.
It's our anniversary sale, and we're celebrating over 85 years of comfort. Save 20% store-wide with a donation of $20 or more to Ronald McDonald House Charities. You'll feel good in more ways than one. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
There's no time to waste. Get Xfinity TV for just $19.99 a month for 12 months. This is one of the best offers of the year, so get started for $19.99 a month. Plus, get the Xfinity TV Go app included at no additional cost, so you'll be able to watch live TV on any device, anywhere you go. Call 1-800-XFINITY to get a great offer on Xfinity TV, or get started for as low as $19.99 a month for one full year. Call 1-800-XFINITY today.
No fountain of youth? No problem. There may be a new way to help you look and feel your best at any age. Next week, the secrets of plastic surgery. Only on Today.
We gamble on crime. One man set against the worst humanity has to offer.
So they bet on me?
Some bet against you.
For over 30 years, you've heard our jingle. So what does that mean? The largest service center in South Florida. Whether it's in-store or in-home, our certified factory-trained technicians will fix items purchased from us or anywhere else. And of course, it means everyday low prices on a large selection of appliances, electronics, and more. And don't forget to ask about our BrandSmart 110% low price guarantee. Discover the BrandSmart way today.
It's Mattress Firm's Super Weekend Sale. This Saturday and Sunday, save up to $250 store-wide on all the best brands, plus save the tax. Sealy Posturepedic Firm Queen Sets start as low as $449.99, plus save the tax. And Beautyrest Firm Queen Sets are only $549.99, plus save the tax. Plus get 0% APR financing for 5 years and still save the tax. We guarantee our lowest price or your mattress is free. Only at Mattress Firm's Super Weekend Sale.
Get the hottest looks at the back-to-school sale at Shoe Carnival. Dance for the whole family starting at $34.98. And cool athletic style starting at $44.98. Plus, buy one, get one half off, even sale prices. Shop Shoe Carnival today. Shoe Carnival, a surprise in store.
The search continues for 58-year-old William Morlock, the paddleboarder who was last seen a week ago in St. Lucie County. Now, the Martin County Sheriff today said a body was found in the water near the Bahamas. And that is not Morlock. It's connected to a case in the Bahamas. Morlock went paddleboarding at Normandy Beach last Friday night and has not been seen since. His body was found the next day. Well, it has been a week since a Jacksonville boy disappeared. Now the reward to find Lonzie Barton is being increased. It now stands at $10,500. Police are looking at surveillance video from businesses near Lonzie's home for images of that car there, driven by the mother's boyfriend, Reuben Ebron. He initially told authorities that Lonzie was in the car when it was stolen. Ebron is now facing two child neglect charges. And a new big cost looming for an after-school program that serves hundreds of kids. The Boys and Girls Club of the Glades could have to fork over up to $170,000 to the school district this year to pay for the building it uses. The Now's Gabrielle Saran joins us now. And Gabrielle, you talked to the CEO and she says it's something they just can't afford, right?
Mm-hmm. Ashley, the Boys and Girls Club is a popular option for after-school care for working parents. But the club says a bill of this size it's never had to pay before is just too high. Nancy Lopez is signing up her five-year-old for camp at the Boys and Girls Club inside Gladeview Elementary.
I wouldn't have no one to take care of him. He's only 5 years old. And for him to get off the bus and go to an empty house is not, you know, I can't have that.
She's a single mom and works full time. Her youngest will be joining her two older kids.
They love it. They like coming here. They don't like being home, being bored.
It's critical. It's necessary because without us, these children would really not have an option.
Jeannie Miranda is CEO of the Boys and Girls Clubs. She just got a notice that the club may need to pay the school district for custodial costs at six schools for the first time. A hit of up to $170,000 a year.
That can mean closing some school sites.
In an email, a school district spokesperson said nonprofit groups pay on a sliding scale. Some pay more than others, but the spokesperson says to report that the Boys and Girls Clubs will have to pay anything is extremely premature. Still, Miranda is scrambling.
I just can't imagine sending 1,000 kids out onto the streets, which might happen if we can't absorb these costs.
The CEO of the Boys and Girls Club says she's hopeful this will be resolved. A meeting with the school district is scheduled for August 10th. Gabrielle Saran for The Now, South Florida.
All right, tracking some thunderstorms all up and down the area. Right now, Treasure Coast, you're okay. You had a big thunderstorm earlier. Now that's gone. You have bigger ones now to the west, but these are starting to die as they push off towards the east. Bigger problem down into Palm Beach County now, where it has been dry most of the day. Things are really starting to spark up. Green Acres, a big thunderstorm. It's finally starting to taper off for you guys there to just some light rain. But if you are heading east or west, you're going to run into some heavier rain, especially west back towards Wellington and up into Forest Hill. A little bit farther up to the north, we have, or to the west, Loxahatchee Groves here. You saw one little thunderstorm quickly move on through. Now it's gone, but there's more building your direction. We could see this build back to you. So although you're not seeing rain right now, keep in mind you may see that heading your way. Let's go up to Jupiter too. No rain at the moment, but watch this, how it kind of blows up, starts moving up into Abaco, almost into Abacoa and the Bluffs right now. Give it another couple minutes and it will be there. And this will build all the way up into Jupiter going through the latter part of the afternoon and evening. We'll keep an eye on it here, Ashley.
All right, James, thanks so much. Coming up on The Now, South Florida, caught on camera, a man tries to plow down a group of trees. Why police say he drove right in their path. Teens. Trees. And finding a good deal on plane tickets is hard nowadays. The one airline that is going back in time to get your business.
Palm Beach Maritime Academy has been providing excellence in education for 16 years. We are now accepting applications for K through 11th grade. Come meet the teachers and staff at our next open house. Palm Beach Maritime Academy, where your child's future begins.
This weekend only, it's Bassett's half-off weekend. Get special half-off savings each day, plus save 25% on everything else. This Friday, you'll get an amazing half-off dining tables. Then Saturday, you'll get half off all our beautiful beds and select mattress sets. And finally on Sunday, half off all accent chairs and recliners. Bassett's half off weekend. You don't want to miss it.
You've been in an accident, and now you have a choice. You can try to settle it yourself with the insurance company, but they're definitely going to offer you the least amount of money. You could call an attorney referral service, but why let some stranger pick an attorney you may know nothing about? Or you can call Rubenstein Law at 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Just last year, we recovered over $75 million for our clients. The choice is yours. Rubenstein Law.
Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL.
This is the last weekend to take advantage of the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale, where you'll find incredible once-a-season savings in every department. Dramatic summer clearance sale reductions on our incomparable room packages. Save big on a ton of special clearance buys. There's even interest-free financing. But when it's gone, it's gone. So don't wait. Hurry to the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale before it ends at 9 p.m. Monday. It's the perfect time to buy furniture.
Get this. I was at my shop, tied up with a customer when I realized the time. I had to get to the bank before it closed, so I made a break for it. When I got out, it was almost closing time. Traffic was bad. I knew I was cutting it close. But it was okay. I use TD Bank. It's got the longest hours and stays open an extra 10 minutes every day. I'm Sid, and I bank human at TD Bank.
One thing we can rely on in this house is UVerse high-speed internet.
I've been streaming movies all day without any problems.
UVerse high-speed internet has brought much-needed reliability to our lives.
It's got reliability you can rely on.
AT&T UVerse high-speed internet. With 99.9% reliability, it's one thing you can rely on.
Palm Beach Maritime Academy has been providing excellence in education for 16 years. We are now accepting applications for K through 11th grade. Come meet the teachers and staff at our next open house. Palm Beach Maritime Academy, where your child's future begins.
An Illinois man is facing multiple charges after he allegedly tried to run over a group of teenagers with his car, and it was all caught on camera. Watch this. Cell phone video here shows the car coming down the block, and then it turns onto the sidewalk as the teens start running. They manage to get out of the way. The car then takes off across the grass and down the block. This all happened outside an elementary school in Rockford. Fortunately, police say no one was hurt.
And then he came around this way where everybody was running to, and we all sitting in a group here, and he went down that way and reversed and came back, and that's when he drove onto the grass.
He was coming at us, and he was revving his engine to speed up when he was getting close to people, and when he got close to me, I just jumped out of the way.
Scary moments for those kids. Well, police say it all started when the 56-year-old man learned that his 14-year-old daughter was involved in a fight outside of that school. Need an idea to get your favorite band to come to town? Take a cue from the people in Italy. Well, this is video posted on YouTube, a message to the Foo Fighters. 1,000 fans joining together to play the band's song, Learn to Fly. Not just singers, but drummers, guitarists, the whole production. And it apparently worked. The Foo Fighters posted a message that reads, "How nice. See you guys soon," suggesting the band will indeed be heading to Italy. Great idea. Surprised it worked, though. Awesome. Good for them. Okay, gel manicures rising in popularity, but there are some health concerns. A new type that could give you the same look without the worry. That's next on The Now.
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now. Local coverage everywhere.
We are also getting several of your photos.
Steve Legal.
We still have very heavy rain.
That's right. The big news is the weather.
The only local chopper getting you breaking news first.
Breaking right now. Homes evacuated.
Now that's local coverage you can count on. WPTV News Channel 5.
It's a golden opportunity to discover the leading edge connectivity of the Lexus ES. With available technology to help you find just what you're looking for. Come in to the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, where you'll find some of the best offers of the year on our most luxurious models. Lease the 2015 ES350 for $349 a month for 36 months, and we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
Cell phones and texting cause one in every five accidents. In the time it takes to text LOL, you could end up DOA. Texting and driving can get you killed. Let's get that message out.
The attorneys of Searcy Denny, taking time to care.
It's our anniversary sale, and we're celebrating over 85 years of comfort. Save 20% store-wide with a donation of $20 or more to Ronald McDonald House Charities. You'll feel good in more ways than one. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
It's H.H. Gregg's Super Sale. Get zero down and zero interest till January 2018. Up to 30% off. A Samsung French door refrigerator, now $17.99. Or a washer-dryer pair for $5.99.
Gregg's got it.
Now through Saturday. Zero down and zero interest till January 2018 at H.H. Gregg. Top brands, low prices, fast delivery.
Gregg's got it.
Because 100% whole grain oats are incredibly good for you. Because they're heart healthy. Because they're good for kids and granddads and everyone else in the family. Everything we do is because of what really matters most. The goodness of oats and the people we love.
For over 30 years, you've heard our jingle. So what does that mean? Amazing everyday low prices on a large selection of electronics and more. An expert and knowledgeable sales team that's ready to help. In-home service by our master tech team. From installation to demonstration of the newest home electronics. And don't forget to ask about our BrandSmart 110% low price guarantee. Discover the BrandSmart way today.
Right now, people.
worst part about eating out is waiting.
Downtown burger with Swiss cheese.
And the worst part about waiting is
watching everyone get their food when you're extremely hungry.
Four Friends Kitchen often has a line out the door, but they don't take reservations. Instead, they use a new app that lets you put your name on the waiting list from the comfort of your own home.
So there it sent you the text, and it's going to show up here in just a little bit.
We put the No Wait app to the test, and sure enough, when my table was ready, I got a text message from the host stand.
So there it does. Shows like the there remote sign and shows the guest app right there.
Awesome.
It's good because it gives you a chance that if you're over at another store or up the street, you know, oh, I've got 10 minutes to get to my table.
The owner says the app is increasing business, making eating here more convenient, especially for families who struggle to entertain kids while they wait.
It's really helped families quite a bit because they can see it, they know they'll come, and then maybe their wait's only 5 or 10 minutes while we're clearing off their table.
This just one of thousands of businesses using the app nationwide, making eating out a better experience for restaurants and customers alike.
Anything else I can get for you?
For the now, I'm Ann McNamara.
All right, right now we're tracking thunderstorms moving all through the area, Treasure Coast and down in the Palm Beach County right now. Very active radar, and you see it starting to spread up into Jupiter right there and to Juneau, Abacoa, and the Bluffs, PGA Boulevard, the Gardens, all looking at torrential rain and even up and down I-95 right now, too, looking like just a mess. Big storms move through central Palm Beach County a little bit earlier. Now it's starting to taper off to just maybe a few light showers. Palm Beach County Fire Rescue reporting some power lines down. Riverbridge Road and Forest Hill Boulevard. Traffic lights out on Forest Hill and near Jog, too. Some traffic lights out there. A couple accidents. And at Aberdeen Lakes Drive, a tree struck by lightning and is on fire. Of course, Fire Rescue is over there taking care of that, too. Another accident, Okeechobee Boulevard, too, that they're reporting and picking up on. So just a mess on the roadways. And all up and down 95 and the turnpike from the heavy rain there. Wellington right now, just heavy torrential rain, and that's all pushing up in the Royal Palm and the Acreage right now. You head east, it does taper off. Lake Worth, Lantana, Hypoluxo, Boynton, all looking at just some light rain. So the heavy stuff, Royal Palm, and also up towards Jupiter to Cuesta. Big thunderstorm here near Hobe Sound. That's starting to spark up, and that will quickly move offshore at the moment. Remember, the bottom of your screen, keep the very latest there of any severe weather, and we don't have any severe warnings, but we do have a couple of advisories out there, and that's for this one here, and then also up on the Treasure Coast, the big thunderstorms that are going on there, and we'll start to move up there, and we'll really see that start to diminish, though, as it pushes off towards the east. Here it is here. You had that big thunderstorm near Vero, and now that's moving on off. So keep with it. We have thunderstorms through the rest of the afternoon and evening hours, and then they'll taper down once the sun sets.
All right, James, thanks so much. Well, you still have time to cash in on a deal from Frontier Airlines. Right now, the company is offering flights for as low as $38. Yeah, $38. Unfortunately, though, the deals aren't offered for flights out of Palm Beach International or Fort Lauderdale, but if you're willing to drive a little ways to Orlando or Miami, you can find some cheap flights there. You'll need to hurry, though, on booking your flights. The flash sale ends tonight. And if you're working too busy, and haven't found time yet to squeeze in a summer vacation, don't fear. Jay Strubberg with our friends at Newsy looks at the timing of taking time off.
Keep going. We don't have it.
We apologize for that. We don't have that ready. We're going to go to something else here. Now, this duct tape story, it's pretty cool. You got to see the pictures of this, okay? For families working to make ends meet, college can seem unattainable without a scholarship. Well, take a look here at what one determined teen did to earn scholarship money. She won second place in a national contest called Stuck at the Prom by making her prom dress entirely out of duct tape. That is all duct tape. Can you believe that? Wow, it looks pretty impressive to me. I wouldn't be able to tell. She convinced her date to make his tux out of tape too, and together they spent 175 hours to create their very own unique outfits that didn't cost a fortune.
Slide a little bit.
Definitely under $75. Like, we thought it would be a lot more, but we ended up only using under 15 rolls of duct tape, and we had our Hobby Lobby coupons and all that, and it was cheaper than most normal prom dresses.
Well, they each won a $5,000 scholarship for their duct tape dress designs. And I bet the guy is now thanking her for convincing him to make the dress right after winning all that money.
Exactly.
That is so impressive to me.
That looked really nice.
Amazing. Yeah. I know. You've seen like the duct tape wallets and things like that. But to make an entire outfit, I mean, the hours
behind
that.
Takes some skill.
It's amazing. Okay, Kelly.
Takes some skill. Coming up today, beginning at 5 o'clock, actually in our 5:30 newscast, you get those telemarketing calls at home and you just hang up on them right away. What if it's a charity, though, that's coming you? And sometimes then you have that tug on your heart, and you're like, should I make a donation? It's a charity that just called me out of the blue. Yeah. We'll have a warning today from John Mattery so you don't waste your money.
Oh, okay. Kelly, thanks so much. Appreciate it. It's important stuff there. Okay, when it comes to getting your nails done, most women prefer gel manicures. It lasts longer, it doesn't chip, but it's not necessarily good for your nails. Not to mention, you have to use a UV light that can cause skin cancer. Our Chrissy Post is here with a new healthier nail trend.
On Davis Islands, word of mouth travels fast.
We're doing a light pink.
Customers at TNL Nails are finding out about a new nail trend called dip powder.
We'll suggest it if we see that, you know, they've tried the gels, it's starting to weaken their nails.
Owner Mai Ven says unlike gel, the powder doesn't use a UV light and won't damage your nail bed. It also doesn't smell, feels lightweight, dries fast, and lasts up to 2 weeks.
It takes about 3 layers to get the true color.
By dipping your nails in the acrylic, it creates a hard surface that allows your nails to grow underneath.
The dip works out much better for me because my nails have gotten very brittle. And they've also started breaking in places they never did before.
Whether you like sparkles or a natural-looking nail, there are 65 colors to choose from. The downside, though, is you have to file or drill your nail before it's finished. And if you're not careful, the acrylic can crack. As for getting the powder on your toes, there will be no dipping.
They've really enjoyed it.
But despite those downfalls, Venn's clients say it's a manicure with a lot of upsides. And from here, they expect the popularity to grow.
Yeah, I've been very happy with it.
For the now, I'm Christy Post.
All right, that's it for the Now South Florida News Channel 5 at 5 begins right now.
We'll suspend at sunset tonight.
We're going to get to that story in a moment about the two missing teens who have dominated this community's attention. The Coast Guard search ending, families gathering together, a community gathering together. But first, our meteorologist has alerted us to severe weather moving in right now.
Let's go over to James Whelan. Also, some power lines down. We're hearing it's nasty out there, James.
Yeah, it really is. We have a severe thunderstorm warning until 5:30 for North County. This is what it looks like up and down I-95. Worse in some areas, especially this is 45th Street. You head farther up to the north. And let's go to the radar, and this is what it looks like. Just nasty out there. So severe thunderstorm here. 50, 60 plus mile per hour winds with this. Hail possible. Torrential rains. And you see here's 95 and Turnpike here. So it's just pushing to the east now, right into the middle of the town of Jupiter. To Cuesta and farther down to the south, Juneau Beach. This severe thunderstorm warning stretches all the way down into the gardens, too, from this storm that's kind of been building all afternoon. We've been telling you about it. I've been telling you it's going to start to move into Jupiter, and it really, really started to spark up, too. Moving over into Jupiter Island also and up into Hobe Sound, very strong thunderstorm here. Again, this goes until 5:30, the severe thunderstorm warning, meaning severe weather is happening right now. That's what a warning means. Also, back towards the acreage, more big thunderstorms, and that stretches back the beeline, too. So all of this has to push on through before we can settle things down. And that's not going to happen, at least for a little while, say an hour or two, before we'll start to taper things off. The Treasure Coast, you had big thunderstorms early and a severe thunderstorm near Sebastian. Now things are tapering off. Big thunderstorms to your west, but they won't make it all the way to the east. We're really focused on this right here. All of this from Jupiter, Juneau, the Gardens, North Palm Beach, Riviera, also looking at some rain there. The bigger thunderstorm, though, moved off for you. And farther back to the west into Wellington, the Acreage. Look at that big thunderstorm right on top of Wellington. Finally moving out of your area, moving into the western suburbs of West Palm Beach right now, say Okeechobee, Sandsbury area. And then that will move up into the gardens too. Farther down to the south, we're starting to taper it off there. Boca, you didn't see a whole lot. Delray either. Lantana, Lake Worth, you're looking at just some light rain at the moment. We're going to keep these thunderstorms in the forecast through about sunset. Then we'll taper those down and stick to partly to mostly cloudy skies. I'll have more updates to come. Back to you guys.
Today we're going to do everything we can to bring these boys home shortly.
Breaking now, the U.S. Coast Guard is in its final hours of searching for missing Tequesta boaters Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen.
A live team coverage on the Coast Guard's decision and the family's desire to carry on. And we begin with News Channel 5's Jay Cashmere at the Square Grouper, where the community rallying around these families coming together yet again.
We're here at the Square Grouper right alongside the Jupiter Inlet here tonight, where this night is being dubbed a night of hope. You can see behind me a number of people have gathered tonight. As one organizer told me, this has been a raw, emotional week, and today certainly culminated with the Coast Guard announcing they would call off the search at sundown, that they wanted to bring the entire community together. There's a sign here that reads, "Our faith doesn't end, and neither will our efforts," and that's pretty much the motto of tonight. A big crowd here. They have a fundraiser ongoing in a couple hours here. There's donations that people can make here as well. And there'll be a prayer service later on tonight before the band starts. And we're told some family members will be in joining us here tonight as well. Their point really just to increase awareness that just because the Coast Guard search ended or will end, it doesn't mean that the community will stop searching. And again, all of this comes today after the big announcement was made to the family earlier this week, but it became public that the Coast Guard would in fact cancel their search at sundown today. That is the latest from the Square Grouper. Back to you.
Crews with the Coast Guard, Navy, and Air Force have been searching from Florida to South Carolina for Austin and Perry. They said it was a gut-wrenching decision. But again, as you've heard, those efforts will end at sunset. News Channel 5's Jared Werksma is live from Coast Guard Station Miami with more on that. Jared?
Well, we are still waiting on official word from the Coast Guard about whether or not they will continue the search for Austin and Perry or if it will suspend at sunset today, as we were told just a few hours ago during the live update behind us here at the Coast Guard station at noon. But one thing the Coast Guard made very clear during that update is that they believe one of their largest search efforts in history is going to come up short. Over the last 7 days or 168 hours of round-the-clock searches, the Coast Guard explained this afternoon its technology, its vessels, and its partnerships with Homeland Security and a dozen other agencies provided genuine hope that they would find Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen alive. But now that 26 planes, 4 helicopters, and 31 boats have searched nearly 50,000 square nautical miles, the Coast Guard explained that it has done everything that it can.
I know those statistics will not ease the pain of the families. But I hope at some point in the future, they can take solace from the fact that hundreds of people searched thousands of miles because we were desperately committed to try to find Austin and Perry.
All right, now once again, we are still waiting on official word from the U.S. Coast Guard about the status of today's search. They said they would continue to search, looking for any sign of Austin and Perry until sunset tonight. They say they will suspend the search at sunset if they don't find anything. And as soon as we hear from them, we'll make sure to get that to you. You can follow me for live updates also at Jared Werksma on Twitter. And we'll be back on air here in about a half an hour to give you the latest. But for now, we are reporting live from the U.S. Coast Guard station in Miami-Dade County. I'm Jared Werksma, WPTV Channel 5.
Austin Stefanos' father posted this to Facebook just this afternoon. Just gut-wrenching post here. Eyes in the sky. No other place I'd rather be at this time. I've never wanted to be my son's hero so badly. Just imagine what these families are going through. The families are vowing to continue searching, and News Channel 5's Brian Ninton is right now in their neighborhood in Tequesta.
These families are not giving up hope right now in the home behind me. They are coordinating private search missions. They say they are thankful to the Coast Guard, but they will continue this search for Perry and Austin. With the Coast Guard suspending their search at sunset, Austin and Perry's families are looking for help.
We have reached out to many ex-military, people that have special training, and that's That's who we need.
Perry's stepfather says they are determined. They've raised more than $300,000 through GoFundMe alone. The private search for Austin and Perry is very much alive.
We know there's a window here. We think there's an opportunity, and we're going to do everything we can to bring these boys home shortly.
Austin Stefano's dad posting this on Facebook. Eyes in the sky. No other place I would rather be at this time. I have never wanted to be my son's hero so badly. The families are asking anyone with prior military search and rescue experience to email findperryandaustin@gmail.com. Meanwhile, Congressman Patrick Murphy says he wants the Coast Guard to keep searching. He believes those boys could still be alive because the ocean is so warm this time of year. Into Cuesta, I'm Brian Enton, WPTV News Channel 5.
Please stay with News Channel 5 and WPTV.com for any new information on Austin and Perry. Remember, you can get push alerts on the search automatically sent to your phone 24/7. Download the WPTV app for that.
The Coast Guard is searching between Daytona Beach and Mount Pleasant, South Carolina for a missing paddleboarder. William Morlock was last seen a week ago Friday night. He was at Normandy Beach in St. Lucie County. Since then, search teams have covered more than 10,000 nautical square miles. They did find his paddleboard, and his car was in the parking lot at the beach.
Orlando police are investigating a double murder involving a couple who had recently moved there from Royal Palm Beach. And now they're asking for help in finding the killers. News Channel 5's Tanya Rogers joins us with more. Tanya?
Well, Michael, Orlando police detectives saying the person or the people responsible for these deaths are depraved. Depraved because this couple was killed in front of their two-year-old son. And officers say it was clear from the crime scene those parents did everything they could to protect their little boy.
It was very shocking.
Rayshon Collins remembers the phone call. His older sister Renee and her boyfriend Peter Sindelholm had been murdered in their Orlando apartment.
I still didn't even believe it until the funeral, honestly.
Police say the couple was murdered on July 17th in front of their two-year-old.
They say they discovered two people dead inside a unit after receiving a call about it.
This is easily one of the most violent scenes that I've ever been to.
The loss of Renee has left family members and neighbors stunned.
She was quiet sometimes. And she was always cheerful, you know, laughing, making you laugh.
Renee's brother, Rayshon, also wants to remember the good times and her talks encouraging him to go to college.
You know, at first I was considering not going to school, but, you know, I know that she would want me to go. So that's all I've been focused on, and just staying strong and just trying to, you know, not think about it too much.
Now, there is a $5,000 reward in solving the case. Orlando police are hoping that people, they're reaching out so that the public will hopefully give them some leads. Tanya Rogers, WPTV News Channel 5.
The mayor of West Palm Beach and local ministers are taking steps tonight to put an end to gun violence. Just last week, four people were killed in West Palm. The mayor and community leaders are planning to march to all of the sites where those killings occurred. News Channel 5's Alyssa Hyman joins us now live from Friendship Missionary Baptist Church on 3rd Street with more on the march. Alyssa?
Well, the whole point is to have a presence in the community, show everyone that they're aware of what's going on, and show everybody that they're here to help and help stop the violence. Now, in less than an hour from now, folks will be gathering here at the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church here on 3rd Street. And the plan is to walk from here about 2.5 miles towards Tamaran to the different locations of the shootings and stop at each one, say a prayer. Now, last week here in West Palm Beach, it was a violent week. At least four people lost their lives to gun violence. Police and the mayor saying there are gangs retaliating against one another, a cycle of violence the community wants to see end. And they're all gathering here to start, and it's a multi-layered issue, but they're trying to have a presence.
We just want to unite as a city to show that you know, we're in prayer, we recognize what's happening, and we're going to do what we can to help.
Now, again, this community peace walk begins here at 6 p.m. tonight, and we are again on 3rd Street at the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church, and we'll hope that the rain clears up by that time. Reporting live in West Palm Beach, Alyssa Hyman, WPTV News Channel 5.
We turn to presidential politics now. Several candidates headlined by Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton, who are vying to be the next president, in Fort Lauderdale today, speaking at the National Urban League Convention. News Channel 5's Andrew Ruiz was there and reports on their messages.
Things heated up here in Fort Lauderdale as two major presidential contenders, Hillary Clinton and Jeb Bush, made their pitch to the black community. Anticipation built as members of the National Urban League awaited to hear from five presidential hopefuls. Of most interest, the two who are no strangers to the White House or American politics.
It could be an advantage, it could be a disadvantage, but again, it's important to hear what everyone has to say.
Hillary Clinton's campaign message weaved into her speech on racism and inequality. It hit closest to home for the crowd.
I don't think you can credibly say that everyone has a right to rise and then say you're for phasing out Medicare or for repealing Obamacare. People can't rise if they can't afford health care.
Jeb Bush came in touting his accomplishments as Florida's governor. He says his record of serving the African American community will serve as a building block for the future.
I know that there are unjust barriers to opportunity and upward mobility in this country. Some we can see, others are unseen, but just as real.
Also on deck, Martin O'Malley, Dr. Ben Carson, and Benny Sanders. All who attended say they took something away from the conversation. For both Hillary and Jeb, this was the first time that they were in the same room while any of them were speaking. They're just going to wait and see how this all plays out, especially with the first debate next week. In Fort Lauderdale, Andrew Ruiz, WPTV News Channel 5.
Uber and Lyft pulled out of Broward County today, and Broward threatens it may sue the ride-sharing apps if they pick up riders in Palm Beach County and drop them off across the county line. Our consumer watchdog, Jen Strathman, shows you how what's happening to our South may well have an impact on Uber's future right here. Jen?
Well, you can't get an Uber ride in Broward over regulations like fingerprint background checks. Uber's message to Broward riders, it was forced out, 2,000 jobs gone. But just because the ride-sharing app isn't picking anyone up in Broward County doesn't mean it won't drop you off there. Uber told drivers in this email that it's okay to drop off riders in Broward County. But Broward says if that happens, they'll sue, already drafting a lawsuit. But drivers in Palm Beach question how this effort will be policed.
I don't think Uber would tell us to do something that there was an express, you know, statute saying don't do that. If I have a client in my car, I'll take them wherever they want to go.
Uber says it may leave Palm Beach, too, if commissioners here move forward with similar rules as Broward. A vote here is expected in mid-August. And already, Uber drivers are preparing for the worst. I'll have that part of the story at 6. I'm consumer watchdog Jen Strathman fighting for you.
When we continue, the school year is nearly here, and that means back-to-school shopping. We'll have an early look at some of the best deals for your family.
A new way to prevent a stroke. More on the device that could help millions of Americans.
Then, all new at 5:30, how do you know the caller on the other end of the phone is really with a charity, like they say? The protective action you should take, even if you want to give.
And an update on the severe thunderstorm over Jupiter right now. The strongest winds have moved offshore, but there could be pockets of very gusty winds with this as it moves to the east and also pushes up towards Martin County. I'll have the very latest coming up in just a bit.
On a quiet summer night, it's hard to think about hurricanes, but severe weather can form quickly. Do you have enough insurance? Know your evacuation route? What about a backup plan? Download the Storm Team 5 Hurricane Survival Guide. It's interactive. Just type in your address for a personalized guide. Storm Team 5 and WPTV News Channel 5, preparing you.
Turn to the experts at Carrier and Cousins Air. Call Cousins Air for details today at 1-888-927-8003 or visit us at CousinsAir.com and keep cool.
You want the latest trend, but care how much you spend. It will be your loss if you don't go to Ross.
This outfit is $103 at department stores, but at Ross, it's less than $55.
Gotta go to Ross, gotta go to Ross.
You know the best thing about summer? Summer pizza. And you know the best thing about summer pizza? It tastes light, it tastes fresh, and it's pizza.
This summer, try our new grilled chicken margarita pizza with Roma tomatoes, basil pesto sauce, mozzarella, and grilled all-white meat chicken, all in our thin crust. Get a large for only $12. And save room for dessert with our chocolate chip cookie for only $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza. PapaJohns.com.
If you want to save money on a new RV for thousands less, you will see Trailers, Fifth Wheels, Motorhomes. Prices slashed right to the bone. Palm Beach Outlet has your RV, the perfect one for your family. Palm Beach Outlet has your RV for thousands less, you will see.
Don't miss out on the opportunity to save thousands on a new RV during the Summer Savings Sale, Thursday through Sunday at Palm Beach Outlets.
It's amazing what you can do with a click these days. Just click to check on your nest egg and see your progress. Just click to get personalized advice and grow your savings. And now, just click to take control of your energy use and save money all year long. With FPL's online home energy survey, it's now easier to get customized recommendations to help you save up to $250 a year. Go to fpl.com/easy to save to take the survey and make your bill even lower.
Kids grow up fast, and no matter what size they are, Ross has a huge selection of the top brands to fit them and your budget. Like this outfit, $65.99 at department stores, but if you want it for less than half, you gotta go to Ross.
Storms continue to move through the area for the drive home. You're looking live at I-95 and 45th Street. It's a mess out there. James Whelan's been showing us a line of storms moving through, particularly nailing the Jupiter area. But wherever you are, if you're about to get under the roadway, take it extra easy and extra slow on the commute home. And James will be back shortly with the latest on the weather.
New tonight, the start of school is right around the corner, and that means back to school shopping time. We had News Channel 5's Ashley Hinson find out where you can get the best deals. Ashley?
Well, Kelly, we compared uniform essentials at three popular stores, Old Navy, Gap, and Target. Now, first we looked at boys' flat front uniform shorts. At Target, they're about $14. At the Gap, about $25. And then at Old Navy, the cheapest, at $8. Next, the girls' skorts. A popular one. At Target, it was about $13. At Gap, $25. And then again, Old Navy with the least expensive at $8. Kind of seeing a trend here. Finally, we looked at boys and girls polos. At Target, you'll spend $9. At Gap, you'll spend about $17. And then at Old Navy, you'll pay about $5. Now, I've been looking at the prices for over a week now and notice how often those prices can change day to day, even at the same store. But also notice prices have been dropping with plenty of sales going online and in stores being advertised as the start of school approaches. I'm Ashley Hinson. Kelly, back to you.
All right, so procrastinating may not be such a bad thing when it comes to getting a lower price. Thank you, Ashley. Don't forget our Back to School Expo at Saturday, August 8th at the mall at Wellington Green from 10 to 4. We're going to get your family ready when it comes to school supplies, uniforms, different schooling options, all you need to know about immunizations, this and more. Plus, you can meet News Channel 5 personalities.
A health alert tonight, a new treatment for a deadly heart condition that affects millions of Americans. Atrial fibrillation, an irregular heartbeat that can lead to stroke. The treatment, though, involves implanting a device into an area of the heart where blood clots mostly form, or commonly form, I should say. The idea, stop the clots from escaping that area.
Acts like a filter that won't allow the clots to travel all the way up. The idea was to see whether we can spare the blood thinners by basically eliminating the source of the clot.
Now, the device will not cure atrial fib, but it can help prevent stroke. And most patients, we're told, can stop medication, stop the use within 45 days.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Boy, it's a mess out there right now. A lot of showers, thunderstorms around. We had a few severe thunderstorm warnings, a lot of advisories going on. And this is what it looks like. Temperatures at least cooled down because of that, 74 degrees. And we're looking off to the north, and that's where we're seeing some big time thunderstorms there. We had the severe thunderstorm warning until 5:30. There it is there. So let's zoom in. It's right on top of Jupiter. Now, although the strongest winds are now well offshore and all the lightning going with it, still there could be some pockets of some real strong wind. torrential downpours out there too, and this is stretching up into Hobe Sound area where Martin County hasn't seen much. Now you're starting to get in on the action here from Hobe Sound. Stewart, not a lot at the moment, but you head over to Sailfish Point, you see a strong thunderstorm there, and then also back to the west moving towards Indian Town, coming off the lake. That's going to come get you too. None of this area has been worked over, so this will start to blow up as it moves off towards the east too. West Palm Beach, we're tapering down to just some light rain, and farther south, just some light rain too. Here's a closer look at Martin County too. Big thunderstorm coming in off the lake, and this will move towards the coast here going through the afternoon, the latter part of the afternoon and the evening hours. Fort Pierce now, starting to see something starting to bubble up here, and that's going to move towards you in St. Lucie County, up towards Vero. Quick moving thunderstorm now dying out. It's moving into the air that was kind of worked over earlier by big thunderstorms. So notice the lightning strikes go away. Still could be some gusty winds with that as it heads straight for Sebastian, where you saw 43 mile per hour wind gusts there earlier. That will continue to move off the coast too. Farther down to the south, a lot of lightning in South County, but not a whole lot of rain. We'll start to see this start to build in with just some light to moderate rain through the evening hours. So if you do have any evening plans to head on out, take the umbrella. You're probably going to need it for a little bit through about 9 o'clock or so. And look at this, just heavy rain moving through Jupiter right now. In fact, we have a camera there, Indian Town and Military Trail. Wet roads here, and traffic's starting to go freely, so that's nice. There are reports of some numerous accidents up and down the road, so be careful of that. And remember, keep the headlights on, and the flashers off. That's the Florida law. You can't drive with your hazards on. It confuses everybody out there. All right, hour by hour forecast. Again, let's go through 8, 9 o'clock with the rain. Then it'll taper on off, and we'll have partly to mostly cloudy skies overnight. Check it out. On top of us, just a mess. This ain't moving. We're going to see the same thing tomorrow with numerous showers and thunderstorms once again firing up. However, as we get into late Saturday and Sunday, picking up more of an onshore flow, and that's actually going to help us out a little bit with the rain and start to back off those rain chances. So 10, 11 o'clock gone. We go into tomorrow morning, mostly cloudy skies, not a whole lot of sun tomorrow, but still showers and thunderstorms start to get going in the afternoon, moving west to east and then pushing off the coast there by Saturday. So still hefty rain chances on Saturday, but we're lowering them now for Sunday, Monday, and on into early next week with more of an onshore flow. Boating forecast, the seas are okay, but you get underneath one of those showers of storms, moves very, very quickly out there, and that wind going to switch on shore too in the afternoon. Highs will be into the low 90s, lows into the middle 70s, and that pretty hefty rain chance only on Saturday, then tapering down after that.
James, thank you. Caught on camera, she wanted her car repaired, but we'll tell you about the adventure her car went on instead.
And all new at 5:30, why former FSU star Jameis Winston once again making news, this time on day one of Bucs training camp.
Closed captioning on WPTV is sponsored by Bethesda Health.
Fresh off the list, freeze your fat away. Yes, science has proven it works. And keep your canine cool this summer with these three things. If it's totally rad, it's on the list.
Tonight at 7 on News Channel 5.
Ed Horst is gonna save you.
Big selection means big savings. It's the big one sales event this month at Ed Morse Delray Toyota. Save big with zero down on new Camrys. Lease for $189 a month or buy for $18,988. Visit DelrayToyota.com.
This is the last weekend to take advantage of the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale, where you'll find incredible once-a-season savings in every department. Dramatic summer clearance sale reductions on our incomparable room packages. Save big on a ton of special clearance buys. There's even interest-free financing. But when it's gone, it's gone. So don't wait. Hurry to the Rooms to Go Summer Clearance Sale before it ends at 9 p.m. Monday. It's the perfect time to buy furniture.
Now at Bremen BMW, drive the new 2015 BMW 320i sedan for only $249 a month.
At the Indian River Press Journal, we cover local. With the largest news gathering operation in Indian River County. Stories affecting your life right now. And those shaping your future for tomorrow. The environment. Education. Crime and politics. Indian River County is growing, and so is the Indian River Press Journal. And TC Palm Social and the Press Journal is your guide to fun in and around Indian River County. Things to do, things to see, things to try. At the Press Journal and tcpalm.com, we cover your backyard every day. Where you live, where you work and play. The Press Journal and TC Palm, online and on time.
Savings. It's the big one sales event this month at Edmore's Delray Toyota. Save big with zero down on new Camrys. Lease for $189 a month or buy for $18,988. Visit DelrayToyota.com.
When a Colorado woman brought her car to be repaired at a Denver area car dealership, she expected, like you would, that it's going to be well cared for.
Sure. But video from her dashboard camera caught an employee using the car to run errands. Really? The employee drove 200 miles over a four-day period. Even worse, the employee ran a red light. It was right there on the dashboard, a dash camera. That employee has been fired from that Denver dealership, and the dealership says they're working with the owner to resolve any issues with the car.
I'm Ashley Hinton live in the newsroom. Coming up all new at 5:30, they are not ready to throw in the towel, and neither are their supporters. See how the families of two missing teens are mapping out their own strategy to bring the boys home. Then, will this vital resource stay open? The unexpected expense that could close the doors on a program designed to help some of our neediest children. And is it legit? We all get the phone calls asking for donations. Some say they're charities, but are they? How you can tell for sure. Those stories and more next at 5:30.
The Business Report on WPTV is sponsored by your local Toyota dealers.
These days, saving on your next getaway is just a click away. And now, just click to see what kind of results you can get with FPL's online home energy survey. Go to fpl.com/easy to save to make your bill even lower.
If you want to save money on a new RV for thousands less, you will see trailers, fifth wheels, motorhomes, prices slashed right to the bone. Palm Beach Outlet has your RV, the perfect one for your family. Palm Beach Outlet has your RV, thousands less, you will see.
Don't miss out on the opportunity to save thousands on a new RV during the Summer Savings Sale, Thursday through Sunday at Palm Beach Outlets.
You know the best thing about summer pizza? It tastes light, it tastes fresh, and it's pizza.
Try our new grilled chicken margarita pizza, a large for only $12, and add a chocolate chip cookie for only $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza, papajohns.com.
You want the latest trend, but care how much you spend. It will be your loss if you don't go to Ross. You'll find some at your store, and you are sure to score. Gotta go, yeah, yeah, gotta go to Ross. You want the latest style, then this should make you smile. At Ross, you'll make a haul, just forget the mall. There's just one place to go for all those in the know. Gotta go, yeah, yeah, gotta go to Ross. Gotta go to Ross, gotta go to Ross.
Now at Empire Today, save big on new floors with our buy one, get two free sale. Buy floors for one room and get carpet, hardwood, or laminate for two more rooms free when you pay for padding and installation. Empire makes flooring easy. We bring samples to your home, give free estimates during your appointment, and professionally install your project right. So save big with Empire's buy one, get two free sale. Schedule now.
800-588-2300, Empire.
Today.
Teamwork, over 35 years experience. At Searcy Denny, we have an experienced team to pursue justice.
At Searcy Denny, we pursue justice if you're a victim of an auto or trucking accident. Learn more at searcylaw.com.
With just a click, it's easy to turn any night into family movie night. And now, just click to save up to $250 a year on your energy bill. Go to fpl.com/easy to save and just click to make your bill even lower.
Live, local, from WPTV, this is News Channel 5 at 5:30. Local coverage you can count on.
Lightning and thunder caught on camera here at Jog Road and Boynton Beach Boulevard. Just a scary sight for those on their way home this stormy Friday afternoon. The storms continue to move through our area. Let's get right now to Storm Team 5 meteorologist James Whelan on where they are right now and where they're headed. James.
Yeah, Ashley, thanks a lot. We had that severe thunderstorm warning earlier that has been dropped. The strongest part of the storm has now moved offshore and also starting to fire up into Martin County now, too. And up to the north into Vero Beach, you're just looking at some steady rains now, maybe a little bit of gusty wind as the last of your storms move on through. From West Palm to Boynton to Delray and down into Boca, just some light rain. It might be a steady rain through the evening hours. Here's where the severe thunderstorm warning was. You can tell that that has pushed on offshore and up to the north, so that has been dropped. Belglade also looking at a big thunderstorm down there too, and east of Okeechobee looking at a big thunderstorm too that's moving over towards Indiantown. Martin County starting to really fire up here. The coastal section from Hope Sound, Bridge Road, and 995 Turnpike all looks just like torrential rain there. So up and down 95, it will be a slow go of it. Keep the headlights on and the flashers off. Moving up into Stewart, not quite there yet, but it's starting to build up to Sailfish Point, and that will build northward. I wouldn't be surprised up into Jensen Beach here before the evening's up. More coming your way too, heading off towards the east into St. Lucie County, where you saw a little bit, but now you're starting to see some more push off towards Port St. Lucie. Fort Pierce, just some sprinkles at the moment, but notice here west of Port St. Lucie, starting to see some thunderstorms fire up as it pushes off towards the east. Now, I expect the rain to last into the evening hours and then taper off. We do it all again tomorrow. I'll have more on that coming up in just a bit.
All right, James, thanks so much. Right now, we are getting word that FPL is working to restore power after thousands of outages from this storm. As you can see here, the most outages, more than 2,000 recorded here in Palm Beach County. The Treasure Coast counties experiencing just sporadic outages. So make sure everyone's staying safe out there as these storms roll through. Okay, right now at Square Grouper in Jupiter, supporters for Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen's families are holding a night of hope on this, the night of the blue moon, hoping for a miracle. The family's vowing to continue the search for the boys despite the decision by the Coast Guard to stop searching for the 14-year-olds at sunset. The U.S. Coast Guard says it's done all it can to find Austin and Perry. The Coast Guard, Navy, Air Force have been searching from Jupiter to South Carolina for the sequestered teens. News Channel 5's Jared Werksma is in Miami with what led up to that decision to stop searching tonight. Jared.
Well, I just got off the phone with the U.S. Coast Guard, and while they don't have any new information for me, I did get some new details at the very least. They say that if this search is going to be suspended tonight, that will not happen until after 8 o'clock, at which point we will get an update. But if they do see anything else in the meantime, that will be reported right away. Now, the Coast Guard says whatever happens in the next couple of hours, they are hoping that at the very least, all of the media attention on this search will help other families avoid a similar fate. The Coast Guard says the last 7 days of searching for Austin and Perry has turned into one of its largest and most collaborative searches in its history. More than 60 vessels scoured the sea and the air 24 hours a day, covering around 50,000 square nautical miles. The Coast Guard says it never would have been possible if not for the incredible drive and cooperation to find these teenage friends.
Between the Coast Guard, our brethren in the Department of Homeland Security, Department of Defense, our state and local partners, as well as the government of Bahamas.
Captain Mark Fedor says there is one thing that would have helped them find the boys' 19-foot boat much more quickly. And he hopes every boater who sees this story will get one.
We highly recommend all mariners utilize EPIRBS, electronic position indicating radio beacon. It's the best way to help us find you if you are in some type of emergency at sea.
All right, now once again, the Coast Guard says that if they are going to suspend the search tonight, that will not happen until after 8 o'clock. But we are keeping an eye on all of our phones and making sure that if anything else is spotted in the meantime, that we get that information to you immediately. You can continue to follow me for live updates on Twitter at Jared Werksman. We'll have another update for you on air live at 6 o'clock. But for now, we are live outside of the U.S. Coast Guard base in Opopka. I'm Jared Werksman, News WPTV, News Channel 5.
Jared, thanks so much. And the story just continues to generate interest, not only here locally, but really across the country, with people weighing in on Facebook and other social media sites as well, many expressing their support for the families. And this poem here to Austin and Perry, which has now been shared hundreds of times. Also, some new information tonight. We've now learned a fourth person. This woman, Carla Laster, has died from weight loss surgery with a doctor in Mexico. The same doctor linked to at least three other deaths and more than a dozen injuries. It is the latest in new concerns that have surfaced about the South Florida company sending patients there. Contact 5 investigator Katie Legrone with what the experts describe as the first signs of trouble. Katie.
Ashley, it is not unusual to go abroad for surgery. Patients can save up to 80% on some procedures.